I've always thought of myself as a lucky person. I don't mean in the sense that, you know, like I've been at the Kentucky Derby and the guy saying, hey, Nicky W. in the sixth, but opportunities that have come my way for my limited abilities, and I say that in all due respect, that I'm almost going to digress, because at the age of, I believe I was 11 or 12, I got polio. And it wasn't of the limbs, but, you know, in the torus, your neck and this area supposedly is the most prone to either disease or whatever. Anyhow, I got polio of my throat and everything, and it left me with no muscles in my lips. I could never blow up a balloon. So in the early days, I had to do exercises to try and strengthen my lips, which in why I ended up a woodwind player. And in these later years, my lip strength has really dwindled. But I believe that was my only serious illness. I spent a summer in a hospital with polio. That I was lucky that, you know, guys were had braces and were, you know, all sorts of debilitating things happened to them. But again, I do feel that I was a very lucky guy in being able to have these experiences musically. And, you know, it enables you to meet so many people that you would normally never have, and again, strike up friendships, which, you know, comes back to my core values of the meaning of life. And I can remember sometimes sitting around with Jimmy and everybody and knowing I'm listening to what they're talking about, and I'd say something like, well, you know, guys, let's talk about the meaning of life, you know. And everybody would crack up and start laughing. I go, what are you doing? You know, man, come on, man, smoke another joint or whatever. But later on, those kind of things, you know, for me, come back. And again, you know, once you've started a family and whatever, and you find out where your priorities are, then, you know, certain things have more meaning than others. And for me, I again feel that I've been a very lucky guy. And still at this point, starting to go back out and play some Zappa stuff, but more so do what we want to do. You know, a lot of times you're really restricted, I think, in the amount of material or whatever that you can play. And we can go from avant-garde-ism again to R&B, whatever. And I think that freedom is very enjoyable to even think about being able to do. And I find that as another very lucky scenario to look forward to. And I'm not that I'm tired of teaching, but there's a lot that I think is self-gratification, as it is, as it were, in being able to perform Frank's music and do our own stuff and perform it at a level that we can be happy with. So again, I'm very optimistic on being able to do that. And as long as my health can last, I've spent most of my life trying to take care of myself, so I see that at least evolving for a little while. And not to throw in a couple of things, but I think I mentioned that I've been a member of the YMCA for the last 30 years. And, you know, I've looked at all forms of workouts, whatever. And I used to run and do a lot of things. But the last 20 years, mainly a swimmer.